Hi, hello everyone. Today we are going to see about the reactions of organometallic complexes, right? So first of all, we are going to see about the reactions involved in metal carbonylate ion complex, and the reactions involved in metal hydride complexes, and reactions involving metal halide complexes and nucleophilic substitution reactions, right? So the first thing is metal carbonylate ion complexes, right? So first we need to know how to prepare this metal carbonylate ion. So the method used for the preparation of a metal carbonylate ion is reduction, right? So reduction, simply reduction means gain of electrons, right? So gain of electrons. Okay, so let's take the complex Mn by 2 CO by 10. So it undergoes the reaction with sodium, will give a metal complex, metal carbonylate complex, right? So it will give a metal carbonylate complex. It will give a metal carbonylate complex, right? So what happening here? So how this sodium will interact with this complex? Okay, let's see. So first we need to calculate the metal-metal bond of this complex. So as we know, the calculation for metal-metal bond, we have an one formula, which is 18 into n minus total valence electron divided by 2. So n is nothing but number of metals here, the number of metals is 2. So total valence electron over here is 34. So we have 18 into 2 minus 34 divided by 2, which is equal to 36 minus 34 by 2, which is equal to 1. So the metal metal bond over here is 1, right? So next thing is, what is the structure over here? So as we know, the metal metal bond is 1. So usually the this complex does not forms the bridging ligands, right? So 5 carbonyl over here, so 5 carbonyl over for 1 Mn, and another Mn will have the 5 carbonyl, right? Like this. And we are using, so if we have one metal metal bond, so we need to use 2 sodium, right? If we have 2 metal metal bond, we want to use 4 sodium. If we have 3 metal metal bond, we want to use 6 sodium, right? So first of all, here this sodium will donate an electron, so this sodium will donate an electron to this metal, right? And also the sodium will donate, another sodium will donate an electron to this metal, right? So it will fragmented as an radical, so we will form an MnCO5 minus, so 2MnCO5 minus. So like this, this reaction is take place. So let's see here, in this molecule the oxidation state is 0, because all the carbonyl complexes are neutral ligands. So here this complex will have the oxidation state of 0. But in this case, let's see, in this case what happening, oxidation state is minus 1. In this case, the oxidation state is minus 1. So here the gain of electron is take places. So this reaction is called as reduction, right? So this by reduction method, we are obtaining an carbonylate ion complex, right? So let's see another one example, which is same like this. So let's take CO by 4 plus 2Na gives 2CO by 8 CO4 minus, right? First of all, we need to calculate the metal metal bond over here. So as we know, 18 into 2 minus, so 9 into 2, 18. So 8 twos are 16, right? So 14, 34. So 34 over here divided by 2, right? So the metal metal bond will be 1, right? So the formula will be like this. So the carbonyl over here is 4 carbonyls over here, and here we can have 4 carbonyls, right? So this sodium, so we are using a 2 sodium. So we are using a 2 sodium. So 1 sodium will donate an electron towards 1 cobalt, another sodium will donate an electron towards another cobalt. So this will fragmented, we form an COCO4 minus carbonylate ion, right? So this is a metal carbonylate ion. So let's calculate the oxidation state. Here the oxidation state is 0, here the oxidation state is minus 1. So gain of electron is take places. So as usual, the reduction is take places over in this reactions also. So these are the this is the method for the preparation of metal carbonylate, right? Okay, so the next one is we have synthesized some of the carbonylate ions, right? So these carbonylate ions are more basic in nature, and these carbonylate ions are more nucleophilic in nature, right? So among this, which will be more nucleophilic in nature and which will be more basic in nature, right? So to find the basicity and the nucleophilicity of this carbonylate ions, we have some conditions, right? The first one is the negative charge on the metal increases, the basicity also increases. So the negative charge on the metal will increases means the basicity also increases. So the principal quantum number increases, the basicity also increases. So we have 3D, 4D and 5D metals, right? So the 5D metals are more basic than 4D and 3D metals, right? The next one is nature of the ligands. If the complex contains an electron donating group, the basicity will increase. If the complex contains an electron withdrawing group, the basicity will decrease, right? So let's solve one question. They asking an arrange the increasing order of the basicity, right? Let's keep it as 1, let's keep it as 2, it is as A, it is as B. So among these two, which will be more basic in nature? So the first one is charge on the metal. So both metal will have same charge, right? So let's see the next point, principal quantum number. So if the principal quantum number increases, basicity increases, right? So here this is a 3D metal and this one is a 4D metal, right? So the 4D metal is more basic in nature compared to 3D metal. So this complex is more basic. This complex is more basic and also more nucleophilic in nature compared to this complex, right? So let's see the another one example. The charge on the metal is minus 1. Here the charge on the metal is minus 2. So as per our condition, negative charge on the metal increases, basicity will increases, right? So here the charge will be minus 2, here the charge will be minus 1. So obviously this complex will be more basic in nature and also more nucleophilic in nature, right? So so usually our metal carbonylate ions are basic in nature. From that we need to find which one is more basic, which one is less basic. So we have three conditions. By using these conditions, we can find the basicity order, right? Okay. The next one is metal halide complex. So the next one is metal halide complex. The reactions on the metal halide complex. The first of all, we need to synthesize the metal halide complexes. So let's we take the complex Mn by 2 CO by 10. Okay, it will react with 2 sodium to form Mn CO5 minus over here and 2 over here. So again this will going to react with X2. So this will nothing but iodine or bromine or chlorine, right? So let's we draw the structure for this one. As we know, one metal-metal bond over here. So 5 carbonyls are in terminal position, right? So this will sodium will go and reacts with this metal-metal bond, and it will fragmented and forms like a forms this carbonylate ion. So this carbonylate ion structure is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and minus over here, right? So this carbonylate ion is more nucleophilic in nature. So this will go on attack and one X, and this will moves towards here, and the product will be CO, 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 and here the X will become, right? So this is our metal halide complex, right? So let's see, this complex is an 18 electron complex, and this is also an 18 electron, and this is also an 18 electron. Throughout the reaction, the total valence electron of the complexes is not changed, even for the intermediate complexes, right? So this is a very important one. Our reactant and product should be an 18 electron complex. The total valence electron never be changed, right? So let's see, here the oxidation state is 0, our product oxidation state is so plus 1, right? So here the loss of electron is take places. So here the loss of electron is take places. So this halide formation is an oxidation reaction. So this halide formation is an oxidation reaction, right? Okay, let's we take another one complex. So this is Mn by 2 CO10, right? So this is the structure for this. These 5 carbonyls are in terminal position. These 5 carbonyls are in terminal position. So react with sodium. So the reduction take places and we form an carbonylate ion, right? And we form an carbonylate ion. So this will reacts with halogen. This will react with some halogens. We form a metal halide complex, right? We form a metal halide complexes, right? So again, so now this metal halide complexes are let's see, this is an 18 electron complex, and this is also an 18 electron complex, and the structure of this complex is octahedral. So octahedral structure is usually undergoes an dissociation reaction, right? Dissociation reaction, and it will dimerize, right? So here in this case, this metal halide complex undergoes an thermal condition, right? Thermal condition. So now the dissociation of carbonyl will take places. So here the 2 carbonyl will dissociates, and we form a product like this. So here the 1 carbonyl dissociated, and here the X will be there. So the vacant site will be created over here, right? So this X will have 2 lone pair of electrons, right? So here the same case, another one metal halide complexes are there. So X is there. Here the lone pair of electrons is there. So the vacant site will be created over here. So 4 carbonyls are there present in the metals at terminal position. So this lone pair of electron will donate an electron to this vacant site, and this will donate an electron to this vacant site. Our structure will be like this, our structure will be like this, right? So Mn x x Mn CO4, and here another one CO4. So this is the structure for this metal halide complexes. Here see metal halide complexes does not form a metal-metal bond. And then if the halogens are present at the halogens are present at the terminal position, it will earn one electron donor. But it will halogens are present at the bridging. Halogens are present at the bridging means it will donate a 3 electron donor. How it will donate a 3 electron in bridging? Let's see. So this halogens at terminal position, right? So this halogens at terminal position will donate an 1 electron, right? So here the two lone pair of electrons are going to donate over this metal. So overall at bridging position, here one electron, these two electrons donated over this metal. So totally the three electrons contribution take places in this halogens, right? So the three electron contribution is take places over this halogen, right? So that's why in bridging the halogen will contribute 3 electron. At terminal position the halogen will contribute only 1 electron, right? Let's we take this complex. This complex is an 18 electron complex, right? And the metal metal bond is 1, right? So this will go react with sodium. It will forms an A. That A complex will be CO4 minus, right? So this will be our A complex, right? So this, as we know, this metal carbonylate ion complexes are more basic in nature, and these are more nucleophilic in nature, right? So these are more nucleophilic in nature. So this will goes and attack some electrophiles, right? So this, what is the structure of this? So CO is there, and there will be a negative charge, and this will go on attacks over here, and this bromine will eliminate. So our B product will be like this. CO, there will be a 4 carbonyls at center position, there will be a 4 carbonyl at terminal position, and one allylic group over here, right? So this is our B complex. This is one of the applications. Metal carbon bond will be formed, right? So here the metal carbon bond will be formed. So this is one of the applications of this metal carbonylate ion complexes. So this is also one of the application, and this will be a more nucleophilic in nature. So that's why it will goes and attack the electrophilic carbon, right? So this bromine will eliminated and will form a metal carbon bond, right? And here we can obtain a metal carbon bond, and this is one of the applications, right? So let's see, this is an 18 electron complex. So here also you calculate the total valence electron for this. So it will be a 9, and it will be a 2 2 2 2, and it will be 1, because it will here the hapticity is 1, right? Here the hapticity is 1, so it will contribute an 1 electron, right? So 10, so 10 plus 8, 18. So this our product will be also an 18 electron complex. So so the total valence electron is never changed. This is our first and main condition. If the reaction happens, the total valence electron of the reactant and product never be changed, right? So this is also an 18 electron complex, and this is also an 18 electron complex, right? So let's see the another one application. So now this cobalt complex again react with sodium. This will forms a carbonylate ion. So the structure for this is So here the negative charge over here. So this will be a more nucleophilic in nature. So this will go and attack an electrophilic carbon, and this chlorine will remove and will form a product like this CO4 at terminal position and C double bond O R. Right. So this is when this acyl chloride is more electrophilic in nature. So this is more nucleophilic in nature. So this minus will go and attack this electrophilic carbon, right? So we can obtain a product like this. So next one is, again this will react with sodium, will form a complex like this. And here the negative charge over here. So this negative charge will abstract and on halogen, and this will eliminate it, and we can form a product like this. X over here. Then it will undergoes an so this is an 18 electron complex. This is an 18 electron complex. This undergoes an dissociation. So two carbonyl will eliminate it. So it undergoes a dissociation and then dimerization, right? So in thermal condition, so in thermal condition it will undergoes dissociation and dimerization. So we can obtain a product like, so here the one vacant site will be created because one carbonyl is eliminated. So here the one X is there and CO1 carbonyl is eliminated and CO3 is there, right? CO is there and X over here, vacant site will be created and CO3 is there, right? So we can obtain a bridging complex, right? So these are the some of the reactions by using carbonylate ion and the metal hydride complexes, right? So from next video we can see about the metal hydride complexes and the nucleophilic addition, right? So I think this video will be very useful to you. So please subscribe and share my channel. This will motivate me to make more and more video. So thank you.